Color fonts are the latest typographical addition to the web. They're fantastic, and they not only allow you to use one of the color palettes defined in a font itself, but they actually allow you to override or change those colors. This unfortunately might not be as straightforward as it seems. So in this video, I'll show you exactly how color fonts work, how you can view and use available color palettes, and how you can tweak the colors within those color palettes. Let's dive in. The easiest way to explain what color fonts are is to actually show them. So I'm going to switch to Google Fonts now because there's a number of color fonts that are available on Google Fonts just as of recently. And you can find them if you enable this toggle right here, show only color fonts. And you're going to see there's not a lot of those fonts available right now, but I'm sure that they're going to add more as time goes by. And for our demo, let's use the Nabla one, this right here. And you're going to see the difference between this font and a regular standard font is that there are a number of colors in each letter of this font. So there are gradients here, multiple colors, which is not usually available in a normal font. And this is exactly what makes those font look stunning. And within this font, there's actually multiple color palettes, but we'll dig into that a little bit later. And there's a way to actually tweak all of the colors that are specified in this font. If you wanted to use this font, we will have to select it. I'm just gonna click the plus sign right here. And I can view my selected families right here. This is going to be Nabla font, and I can include it if I copy this snippet right here. So I'm going to switch back to CodePen right now, and I'm going to go into settings, HTML, stuff for head, and I'm going to paste those links right here. And now the font is available and I can use it if I just specify the font family defined in Google Fonts, which would be Nabla right here. So I'm going to copy that as well, and I'm going to paste it right here into my H1 font family, and let's see if it works. And sure enough, the font is now available. Obviously, there's a major accessibility problem with this color on this background, so we would want to tweak the colors of that font. Now, here's the thing. It's not really obvious which color palettes are available within this font because Google Fonts doesn't give you any information about that. And different color palettes are defined by an index, but this doesn't give you much info about how many of the color palettes are they and how they actually look. But fortunately, there is a nice little web app called Wakamai Fondue that gives you an insight into a font. So what you do here is you upload a font, and this gives you a detailed overview of everything about the font, including color palettes. So first thing, you would have to download the Nabla font right here. You can download it if you click this button here. And as I already downloaded it, I'm not going to do it again, but I'm just going to drop it right here. So I will select my Nabla regular font file. I'm going to open it, and once it's uploaded, I'm going to see a whole bunch of info about it. Let me zoom this in. There is some info about the typeface right here, and what interests us are the color palettes. So this font has 7 color palettes that consist of 10 colors. So each one of those palettes has 10 colors, and you don't see the white one right here because it blends in with the background, but there are 10 in each one of those palettes. You can use any one of those, and I'm going to show you how. So this works with the font palette values at rule. And the font palette at rule defines a color palette and connects that color palette to a particular font. So let's create that at rule right here. Font palette values. We're going to give it a name, Nabla, just as our font. And here you would specify the font family that you want to apply that to. So we're going to say font family, Nabla. And you can select the palette you want to use available in that font with the base palette CSS property, base palette. And the value here is just the number of the palette that is defined within the font. So if we jump back to Wakamai Fondue, we can select any one of those palettes. This one starts with the index of 0, this is 1, this is 2, this is 3. So if we wanted to use a little bit of darker colors because we have a light background, we could select this one maybe. This is going to be index number 3. So let's jump back to CodePen and select the palette number 3. Still nothing happens because we actually didn't apply the palette to our font, and we're going to apply it right here. Font palette, and the value for font palette will be our name defined right here, Nabla. Let's see if it works. And they actually have a typo here, it needs to be palette, so let's fix that. And once I fix that, you're gonna see that colors have been changed because we have selected this particular palette. And of course, we can select any one of the palettes available right here, maybe switch to 6, all right, 6. And this looks pretty nice. As I already mentioned, you can actually tweak any one of the colors defined in this particular palette. So right here, you see that those are the colors that are specified, and each one of those color palettes has an index starting from 0 all the way to 9 right here. So you could override colors if you just add override colors property. And here, you need to specify the number of the color you want to override along with the value you want to override it with. So if we wanted to override first color, it's going to have index of 0. And for example, we want to override it with completely white color. I'm going to use HSL format here. And I'm not sure if it's noticeable right now because there's a lot of gradients in this font, but let's add a couple more, maybe overwrite first three colors with white. And maybe let's try something closer to dark because we're on a light background here and we have those tweaked colors. And this way you can overwrite any of the colors from the color palette. For this particular demo, we also have a dark mode media query right here. So if I jump into my system preferences and switch to dark mode, you're gonna see that the background is switched to this one defined right here in our media query prefers color scheme dark. And this again becomes inaccessible because those colors are very difficult to read right now. But of course we can select different color palette or different colors entirely for our dark mode. And we would do this if we added another font palette values at rule. And let's call this nabla dark. This is going to stay the same, but I'm gonna change the base palette to a light one. Let's see which one. Maybe the first one is gonna be okay. Let's say base palette is gonna be 0, and we're gonna override colors with white, and we're gonna specify font palette as nabla dark in our media query. So let's do h1 and font palette, nabla dark. Let's see what happens. And sure enough, font has been changed. If I jump back to system preferences and switch to light mode, you're gonna see that light mode features a color font that looks like this, and the dark mode is gonna feature a color font that looks like this, which is really interesting. It gives you a lot of possibilities to tweak those colors within the color font exactly as you see fit. What is the browser support for color fonts? I'm gonna jump to Can I Use right now, and you can see right here that font palette values is supported in Chrome, Edge, Safari, but unfortunately not in Firefox as of right now. So in Firefox, you would have a default color font in all cases that looks exactly like this, because using different palettes or tweaking those colors is not really possible at the moment, but hopefully support will be added soon. I think those color fonts are fantastic. I can't wait to start using them in production as soon as Firefox jumps on board, or right now we can use them as progressive enhancement. In any case, I hope you found this useful and helpful. My name is Zoran Jambor. Thank you so much for your attention. I will see you in the next font, or rather in the next video.